Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining route distinguishers, route targets, and VPNv4 routes in the context of MPLS. Now, this video is a part of a series on MPLS that starts from scratch, where each video builds on the next one. So if you haven't yet seen the previous videos in this series, it's a good idea to do so at some point so that you can get the full benefit of the information I share here today. Also, subscribe, enable notifications to be informed of new videos, and like this video if you like this video. In the previous video, we introduced virtual routing and forwarding instances, or VRFs, and we touched a bit upon how they are used in the context of MPLS to separate one customer's traffic from that of another. We saw how these VRFs are configured on the PE routers, one for each customer network connected there. Now we know that the PE routers use BGP to talk to each other on the MPLS network, where the next hop IP of the IBGP peer is advertised using IBGP peerings. MPLS labels in turn are assigned to those next hop IPs so that the PEs can find each other using label switching. The last piece of the puzzle, however, is this. How does PE1 here know to which PE it should send the packets that are destined for the network behind CE2? What mechanism is used to match up the VRF associated with that customer with the appropriate destination PE? We would like to use the IP address of the customer ideally. However, the problem is that these addresses are not unique. Notice here how these two customers have used the same IP address ranges. In order to give customers the freedom of using whatever IP address ranges they choose, we need something else to make these destinations unique. To do this, we use what are called route distinguishers, or RDs. RDs are 64-bit values that are prepended to these routes to make them unique within this MPLS infrastructure. How is that done? Well, let's take a look. We'll be examining how this network here is advertised such that PE1 here will learn about it appropriately, and in turn, it will inform CE1 of that network. Now, keep in mind that everything we're going to be looking at here is on the control plane. No user data is being exchanged. We're just talking about the advertising of networks. So initially, CE3 here informs PE2 about its 10.10.20.0/24 network using whatever routing protocol is configured between these two devices. Once PE2 receives this, it takes a look at the VRF on which the interface is configured, and it checks to see what RD corresponds to that VRF. The RD is something we configure ourselves. We see that the VRF blue corresponds to RD 100:20. Now this RD value is a 64-bit number, but we often write it in this format with two 32-bit numbers separated by a colon. The first number is that of the BGP ASN, which in our case is 100, and the second number is an arbitrary number. Now, you can actually use any values you like within the range, but the use of the ASN is simply a convention that is often followed. For now, keep in mind that this simply corresponds to a 64-bit value. So this is our RD for VRF blue. What happens next? When PE2 sends out its IBGP update, it will prepend that RD to the prefix it shares, like so. And it will place that within the IBGP update. So now when PE1 receives this, it receives a route with a unique prefix along with the next hop IP of PE2. Now there's a name we give to this combination of the 32-bit IP address with the 64-bit prepended RD, and that's called a VPNv4 route, which is unique to the whole of this MPLS infrastructure. We now have a method to differentiate between the advertised prefixes of our customers. Now take a look at this. Here we see the routes to the blue and green customers being advertised with the RDs prepended. They use the corresponding RD for the VRF in question that's configured in PE2 before being advertised over the IBGP peering. Now, along with the VPNv4 routes, which are composed of that RD and the IPv4 prefix, these IBGP updates between PE routers contain some more information. This is one of the reasons why the protocol being used to share this information is called multi-protocol BGP, because it's not just the IP protocol that's being advertised, but additional information that corresponds to other protocols. Specifically, we are sharing the RD and the IPv4 prefix, which, as we said, constitute the VPNv4 route. We advertise the next hop IP address of the advertising PE router, which is PE2 in our case. And we also advertise one more piece of information. We advertise the VPN label. Now, what is the VPN label? This is where our VRFs meet MPLS labels. Well, let me just reiterate again that we are still talking about the control plane. We're not talking about user data. This is not the header of a data packet. We're talking about route information that's contained within the IBGP update. Now, the VPN label is actually a piece of information that's used on the data plane. So when PE1 receives this IBGP update, it gets the following information: the RD and the IPv4 prefix, which together constitute the VPNv4 route, the IBGP next hop IP, which is that of the IBGP peer that has advertised the route, as well as that new VPN label that we talked about. In this case, the VPN label has a value of 19. So now PE1 has all the information it needs to send user data to this destination on CE3. Now, our PE1 router has learned about both routes on CE3 and CE4, and it has them with the information like so. The only thing differentiating between the two is the RD, but that's fine because they are unique in the MPBGP set of information as destination routes. Now, the PE1 router must share this information with the CE routers so that they know how to reach the intended destinations as well. But there's a problem. There's no information that tells our PE1 router which of the two VPNv4 routes belongs to which customer. An additional piece of information is necessary. And that's where route targets come in. Now, RTs are used to decide to which VRF we import and export VPNv4 routes on PEs. Like the RD, the RT is also a 64-bit value that is advertised between PE routers. It uses the same format of two numbers separated by a colon, but the RT is not shared by default within the body of a BGP update like the RD is, but it is added as a BGP extended community value. For each VRF that we configure in our PE, we must also configure the corresponding RT that will be used to import and export VPNv4 routes. So when PE2 shares the IBGP update for the 10.10.20.0/24 network received from CE3, which is on VRF blue, it uses an RT of 100:30, and it puts that in the BGP extended community. So that when that BGP update reaches PE1, it will use that RT of 100:30 to differentiate between the two routes, and it will know that it must send that over to VRF blue. Thus, the VPNv4 route must be exported to the CE1 router. Now, both the RD and the RT must be configured on all PE routers that connect to this customer's devices, so that the routes will be unique, and so that VPNv4 routes will be imported and exported to the appropriate customer devices. So as you can see, MPLS works with many different technologies: VRFs, RTs, RDs, MPBGP, an underlying IGP, as well as LDP, in order to deliver a robust, efficient network that provides layer 3 VPNs over an MPLS infrastructure to separate the traffic of many customers leveraging that ISP network. So that's MPLS and how it works with VRFs, route distinguishers, route targets, and VPNv4 routes. I hope this was helpful and enlightening for you. For now, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you have feedback or comments, please feel free to write them in the comments below. I always like reading them and responding to them. And please don't forget to subscribe and enable notifications so that you'll be informed of newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.